For the basis, whatever we have learned in dictionary, we are having one program. That means program to store the student's information, which contains the admission number, name, class and percentage. And display the information on the basis of the admission number. Means, agar maine ek bacche ke baare mein, uske admission number aur uski baaki information hai, name, class, percentage, to aise maine kitne number of students ke admission numbers jaane hai, aur kitne bachcho ki mujhe information chahiye. Lekin jo information mujhe access karni hai, ya display karani hai, wo kiske basis pe karani hai? Admission number ke basis pe. Now, for example, I'll start my solution with the help of, I'll take B1 as a variable, as a dictionary, and which is equal to our empty dictionary, that is DICT function, dict function, which means that an empty dictionary will be created in the memory. I've taken I is equal to 1, and no need of taking the flag here because we are not using any flag value here, right? So I is equal to 1, n is equal to input enter size of the dictionary. Now, how many number of entries I want to enter in my dictionary, right? One more thing is this, if I am putting the integer value, so I have to write I is equal to int into input enter size of my dictionary. Now the loop will continue from I less than n, where I stands for 1, so 1 is less than, suppose in n I have entered the value as 5, then it will take the value here as 5. I is 1, n is 5, 1 is less than 5. If the condition is true, the loop will get down. And all the statements which are coming in the same alignment will get executed. Now, if I is 1, then it will ask for the admission number to be entered. That is int within my brackets input, then enter admission number. So, it will ask a question from me, enter the admission number. Suppose I have entered the admission number as 101. Then, name is equal to input enter name. So, it will ask for the name. Suppose the name I have entered, that is love. Now, name class is equal to enter int input. Within my brackets, I have to mention input enter class. And I have to enter the class. Suppose the class is 11. Then is percentage enter float input. I have to enter the value of percentage float input enter percentage. Let the percentage is 79.5. X is equal to, I have taken all three values because these three are my values and this is my key. I am taking it them as values. Matlab one key contain more than one value in it. So, I have placed one variable x is equal to, which contained all three values in it, and we are writing D1 of ADM, means if my admission number is 101, so the admission number 101 will contain all three values in it, right? Now, I is equal to I plus 1 means the value of I will increase from 1 to 2. Now, after the value is increased, the loop will go back to the while loop, here. Now, 2 is less than 5, true. Again, it will ask for the next number. Like, suppose next number, admission number I have entered, let it be say 102. Again, it will ask for the name, let it be say Rajat. Then ask for the class, let the class is 12. And again, the percentage is, let it be say 85.0. Right? And X contain all three values and the dictionary second key value pair will become 102 and rest of all three values in it. Now again the value of I is increased by 3. Now again the loop will go back to the while. It will continue moving till the loop value gets false. Like if the I value becomes 5 is less than 5, if it is false then it will come out of the loop. When it will come out of the loop, then in the same alignment of while, it will move to the next line, that is called as your L is equal to D1.keys function. Means L will contain all the keys of my D1. Suppose I have entered my key as 101, 102, next key value is 103, next key value is 104, and next key value is till 4 it was working because 1 to 4 it will work, right? So all these are the my keys, so it will get the value as 101, 102, 103 and 104. Now I said according to the question I have to display the information on the basis of my admission number. So if I'll say for I in L, it means one by one each key will come. Now for that key, I have to print that key number. So if we print admission number is ABM alone is equal to 101. Now after that, I have written X is equal to D1 of I, where X is equal to D1 of I means इस की पे मेरी जो भी वैल्यूज होंगी डिक्शनरी के अंदर वो एक्स में चली जाएंगी. तो अब वो वैल्यू एक नहीं थी, एक से ज्यादा थी. इट कंटेन्स थ्री वैल्यूज, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई टेकन वन मोर लूप इनसाइड इट. दैट इज फॉर जे इज इक्वल टू एक्स. नाउ जे इन एक्स, नाउ जे विल कंटेन द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. एक्स गेट्स द फर्स्ट वैल्यू एज लव, सो इट विल प्रिंट मी एज लव comma एंड बैक स्लैश टी मीन्स इट विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम लाइन बट इट गिव्स द फाइव स्पेसेस इन इट. After that, again move inside the J loop only and gives the next value as 11. Then उसके बाद percentage देगा, that is 79.5. अब ये inner loop खत्म हो गया. ये inner loop खत्म होने के बाद वो वापस किसके पास जाएगा? Outer loop में. Outer loop मेरा I का चल रहा था. I के अंदर अभी first key value उसने ली थी 101. अब वो कौन सी ले लेगा? 102. So next क्या आ जाएगा? ADMN नंबर इज इक्वल टू 102. एंड 102 पे मेरे पास जो जो मैंने नाम डाला है, जो क्लास डाली है, जो मार्क्स परसेंटेज डाली है, वो डिस्प्ले करेगा. दैट इज रजत. देन इट विल डिस्प्ले 12 एंड देन इट विल डिस्प्ले 85.0 एंड सो ऑन. ऑल फोर रिकॉर्ड्स विल बी डिस्प्लेड इन दिस मैनर. सो अ डिक्शनरी कैन कंटेन वन की विद मोर देन वन वैल्यूज एंड डिक्शनरी कैन ऑल्सो एक्सेस द वैल्यूज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इट्स की. Thank you.